What's up, y'all? We are coming at you today. This is kind of an off day, kind of a random little trip here, but I wanted to bring y'all along with me. I got to run into Walmart to get a couple things, and I want to grab a couple little watermelons, actually, to I got some stuff I want to shoot with them, just testing out a little bit. So I thought while I was in there, I might take a look and see what kind of ammo they got. Today's Tuesday at noon, so I don't really expect a whole lot to be going on in there, but thought I'd bring y'all along for a ride just in case there is something. But we'll go in there and see what they got, and I'll come back out and report it. Guys, also, I just want to, just a quick reminder, man, if y'all watching these videos, hit that subscribe button if you enjoy watching them, keeping up with me, what's going on. We're getting close to 1,000, so y'all hit that subscribe button. But I'm going to run up in here into the Walmart, and I'll get back with you and see what we got. All right, we're here. This parking lot is absolutely jam-packed, man, so I don't know what we're going to have today, but we'll go in there and see what we got, and then I'll let y'all know what happened. Alright, we just came out of there. I don't know what's going on in freaking Walmart today, but I'm going to tell you what, man, that place was a friggin' nightmare in there, dude. It's packed wall to wall. We came out of there, picked up me a couple little pitiful, little sad watermelons, and got me another box here with some boxes in it, so y'all know what that means. We did pick up a little something. This is not my normal day, if y'all know. I do my Thursday things, but Rural King's only 5 minutes down the road. Since I'm already out here, we're going to go in there and check and see what they got. Alright, y'all, we on the way to Rural King, but I want to show you something here. I don't know if this dude does it on the weekdays. Yeah, it looks like he's out there. Y'all keep a look on your right here. Watch as we come up. Let me show you what the big problem here is right now with this ammo. Let me show you why there's such an issue. You see those two trucks right there? You see that sign? That scum rag right there is reselling ammo for about 4 or 5 times the damn price. And that's our problem right now, guys. People like that. And I've several times started to stop by there and tell the scumbag just what a sorry piece of garbage he is, but it ain't worth my time, man. People like that'll get what's coming to them in life. But there's your problems right there, guys. It ain't the shortage, and that's the reason why these prices are staying up, is because of people like that. But anyway, that aggravates the fool out of me. But we almost at Rural King. We'll see what we got in here, and then I'll get back with y'all. Alright, y'all, made it to Rural King, man. That dudes like that down there just aggravates the fool out of me. I know I shouldn't let that people like that bother me. Like I say, they'll get what's coming to them, man, but it's a pain, dude, that people like that make it rough for people who actually buy this ammo to shoot, like myself and several other people do. And even if you're just hoarding it for yourself, it's a whole different story than taking it out here and taking advantage of these good prices and then jacking the stuff up like 5 times, man. I just don't think that's cool. But we're going to go in here and see what they got. All right, y'all, we're back in our favorite store. You know how it is, the Rural King. We got a couple little boxes we're going to pick up in here. All right, y'all, we made it back to the house after our little impromptu ammo run. This definitely wasn't planned. And like I say, today was, if y'all have seen my videos and watch any of them, you know my Thursday's my normal one day a week that I do my ammo thing. So this was completely unplanned. I knew I was getting this little package today, but my main reason, like I was saying, is to go out and get a couple watermelons and shoot. And look at them little pitiful things, man. I mean, that's a daggone pitiful watermelon right there, buddy. If that was a fish, I'd be getting a ticket for undersized catch right there for sure, man. I'd be game warden be putting me in the back of the truck. But anyway, I picked up a couple of them. Luckily, they're only $3 down there, so we're gonna shoot them here at the end of the week with that 44 Magnum I got. I'm gonna do a little bench top review and take that thing out to the range and see if we can bust up some watermelons. But anyway, let's get to the ammo. I know that's what y'all here for. So first thing we did, like I said, went by Walmart, and we actually did pretty good at Walmart. I'll show you what we got. Now, my Walmart has absolutely no limit, and now this is the only thing they had down there today, because old boy down there, I'm sure he's got half of what they did have this morning sitting on his table, or all of it, because they've got no limit, and that's good and bad. Good for people like me who wants to buy stuff to shoot, and bad because of people like him who wants to buy it at normal prices and then gouge the crap out of people for jacking it up 4 or 5 times the price. But y'all see what we got here. We got 6 boxes of 7.62x51 or 308, whichever you want to call it. I thought this was a pretty good price on this. These were $21.84 a box, so $1.09 a round for some 7.62x51. That ain't bad at all. It's around $1 most of the time, so a little bit over even right now. So didn't think that was bad at all. Got 6 boxes of that. I'll shoot this. I've got an AR-10 that
I'm going to do a review on it and stretch some legs out on it here probably in the next week or so and make a video out of it for y'all to check out. So anyway, we got 6 boxes of that for $21.84 a box. Like I say, I thought that was pretty good. I was pretty happy with that. I'm sure they had much more, 22 shotguns and everything before that dude hit it this morning or another one just like him. So anyway, there's a Walmart deal. And then my Rural King, all these stores I've mentioned before are only about 5 minutes apart from each other. So I figured I might as well run on down to the Rural King while I was out. So Rural King, they still had some more of this Top Gun. Y'all saw me, I think I showed a couple boxes I bought of this the other day too. So it's just 12 gauge, it's just 1200 foot per second, 7.5 shots. I'm kind of getting into the shotgun thing here pretty heavy recently, and I want to put some more lower stuff through my little Panzer bullpup that y'all have seen on the video. This was super cheap. This stuff was only $6.49 a box, so for a box of 25, so 26 cent a round for that. I mean, you can't beat that for some target load. So we got that. And then the real score of the day, man, which I was super happy with. Y'all see he was just putting it out when I got there. We got 2 boxes of 300 Blackout, which is really hard to find right now. And if you find it, it ain't that great of a price. You're going to pay usually $1 a round minimum, no matter where you buy this stuff right now. And let me tell you what the price on this stuff was. My jaw about hit the floor when he told me. He told me he was bringing some out, and I figured that's $20 a box. I'll take a couple boxes. $12.49 a box for that 300 Blackout for a box of 20. $12.49, so 62 cents a round for brass case 300 Blackout. You can't beat that with 2 sticks, man. That's a score right there, buddy. And I'll show you how good it is, because I thought I had a score on it sitting in this box right here, but that's right there is a score, man. $12.49 a box for 300 Blackout, 147 grain. I mean, that's a super deal. That's the score of the day, in my opinion, for what I got today. But anyway, that was our little out and about run. And now this is, I was expecting this today, and I actually, it's a good package when it's got that symbol right there on it, buddy. So I was expecting this, and I actually had to wait for it. They had just delivered this, and as soon as they did, I ran out the door and then went and done my little run here. But this is from SigSauer.com. And this is something I didn't really realize what kind of ammo they had and the halfway decent prices they still had on this. I ordered this on the 5th, and the 4th. I ordered this on the 4th, and today's the 9th, I think it is. Yeah, today's the 9th, so 5 days, man, and it's here. It's already here, and that's including the weekend. I ordered it before the weekend on the 4th, and here it is already on a Tuesday, even including the weekend. So if y'all hadn't checked on SigSauer.com, they actually have some decent prices if you're stuck ordering online, and I know a lot of people are. My main reason to going on here was somebody had told me they had a good price on 300 Blackout, and at the time when I ordered it, they did. Now, it's out of stock right now. I just looked. But I got 3 boxes. Their limit is 3 boxes. But if you order $100 or more, you get free shipping through them. So I couldn't get but 3 boxes of this, so I couldn't make up my $100 on this. Now, this is pretty good stuff. 125 grain, 300 Blackout, brass case, just good old 300 Blackout, as you see there. So I bought 3 boxes of this, which was my limit. And this was only $7.65 a box, which is that's really good for 300 Blackout. I mean, I thought that was a super deal until I just hit Rural King today, man. But we got that. We got 3 boxes of that, 300 Blackout, $17.65 a box. So it's only 88 cents a round, which is a heck of a deal right now, man. Plus with the free shipping if you order much. So, but that's where you run into a problem. Their 9FMJ is still for, in this day and time, it's really good for online prices. All of their stuff is decent for online prices, but that's the problem. I really was only looking for 300 Blackout, but to get the free shipping, I think shipping's like $13 if you don't get the free shipping. So I went ahead and I ordered a box of 308 from them. So it's like I say, I'm planning on shooting that 308, 150 grain. So really nice. I mean, good, nice FMJ ammo from them, you know, brass case 308. Now this was a little pricey. This was $27.95, but I mean, if you take, that's probably about $6. Well, that's $6 higher than that. But then if you take take that $6 and divide it into here, it puts this at $1 a round, which is what I expected to pay anyway. So I come out, you know, I come out even there. So I don't mind. I didn't mind that to finish it out for free shipping. And I needed a little bit more to do the free shipping. So at the time, they also had this nice hollow point, these V crowns in stock. Now this is really nice defensive ammo. I've used this in some guns before. This stuff's really nice ammo. It is defensive ammo, so it ain't cheap. It was $1 a round. Basically, it's $52.95. So $1.05 a round. But I mean, that's defensive ammo. A defensive hollow point 9mm is $1 a round. Period. I mean, unless you buy, well, used to, you could buy maybe some Speer Gold Dot 50-round boxes for cheaper. But it's always been right around $1 a round. So I wasn't mad at that. So yeah, we got that. Got the three box of 300 blackout, the one box of the 308, and then the one box of them. Plus this is that nice 124 grain, which in my opinion, that's the perfect defensive weight right there. 124 grain hollow points are my preferred carry ammo. So I didn't really need more carry ammo, but like I say, to add it in and get the free shipping, it was worth it, because the time you take that $13 and spread it between these, you know, it came out to the good, especially with the deal I got on these. Now, the only thing I would say about SigSauer.com is, well, of course, like I say, it's a three-box limit, and you got to figure it out if you want free shipping. But also, I noticed on my order it said adult signature required. So that's why I waited around here half the day, because I figured out, you know, if it wasn't there, I was going to miss it. And they ship it through FedEx, so God knows when they would try to re-deliver or what I'd have to do to pick it up or whatever, and I wasn't going through that. But when the guy got here, I didn't have to actually sign. He said, you are 21, I'm assuming. I said, yeah, and he left. But so I don't know if he would have actually left it or not, though, if I wasn't here to say I was 21. So that's something to keep in mind through them. You know, I'd probably want to be there just to make sure if they did require a signature. But other than that, I mean, and their stock goes out of stock fast, and this is out of stock right now. The V crowns, I think, were in stock right now, and I think this was in stock right now. And at the time of recording this, they had, well, this was out of stock, actually. I just looked. At the time of recording this, they still had this 308, and they had some 243 Winchester, actually, in stock, too. I've seen a lot of people mention that. So, and from what I understand, they usually stock stuff really early in the mornings. I'm talking about like 4 or 5 a.m. in the mornings. So maybe if you get up first thing in the morning, for people who are stuck with no other choice but to order online, I mean, that's the lesser of the evils, really, because that's a real good price on 300 blackout for right now, especially. And that was basically right in line as normal, you know, for good hollow point, 124 grain defensive. And this was a little bit high, like I say, but time you kind of spread it out, it all evens itself out. But and again, this is stuff I can shoot, man. You won't see me selling. I won't sell a round for $500 right now. I mean, that's a little bit exaggerating, but y'all know what I mean. I don't sell ammo, period. That's something you ain't never gonna see me doing. I'll never sell a gun or a drop of ammo unless my family's starving to death and I just absolutely have to have money. So you ain't gonna see that from me. But like I said, yeah, man, I thought that was a real good score. So I don't know if y'all get tired of watching these ammo vids. Like I said, I usually only do one a week, but y'all let me know if y'all getting tired of seeing these. And also, do me a favor, if you will, go down in the comments and let me know how y'all feel about the little vlog style little clips that I put in front of before I get home traveling to the stores. Do y'all like seeing those? Would you rather me cut those out and just get right here to showing the ammo? I kind of like showing the little trips to the stores, and I like watching them on other people's videos. So y'all in the comments down there, let me know if you like seeing those little clips beforehand where I'm going and coming out and all that good stuff. But at any rate, if y'all do enjoy watching my videos, I got some, I'm going Friday, and we're going to do some little bit of shooting and a little review on my 44 Magnum. I got another gun on the way that should be here very first part of next week, if not the end of this week. So I got some good videos coming up. We're right here on the brink of 1,000, man. We're a little over 900 subscribers now. So if y'all ain't subscribed, if you watch these videos, I know, just like all YouTube videos, it's a super low percentage of people who watch that are actually subscribed. So if y'all enjoy, man, hit that subscribe button. I try not to do real clickbaity stuff, and I try to stick to gun stuff mostly, and I throw these little ammos in here and there because I know people like enjoying them. So at any rate, I ain't gonna keep y'all too long. I appreciate everybody that watches. I appreciate everybody who are subscribed. Keep holding strong, and y'all stay safe, stay prepared, and I appreciate everybody watching, and we'll see y'all in the next one.